Did you know that you can use the new experimental resource API to handle streaming requests? Replacing the loader function in a resource with a stream function makes the resource a streaming resource that can handle multiple chunks that are returned in response to a single request. Now, the resource can serve as a container for data that will arrive gradually from the server. Let's look at an example that uses this pattern to get product data from a stream. After assigning the result of our stream to a variable, there are two steps we must take before returning our promise. Initialize the signal and update it as values are streamed from the server. First, we'll create a promise, which will be the ultimate return value. Then, we'll initialize the signal named products with an object that maps the value field to an empty array. The stream function must return a promise of a signal of a resource stream item, the type definition of which is shown here. And here, you can see how our defined type stream item and stream item signal help us adhere to that requirement. Next, we'll update the product signal with each new value that's returned from the stream. The resource API is currently experimental and might change, so we'd love your feedback on this one. Be sure to upgrade to the latest version of Angular. Give it a try.